Greetings from Istanbul Technical University. This is Badr. I am the team leader of ITU Rover Team. Last year, we did our first appearance at the URC. Now, we are proud to announce our next generation rover with major improvements and a brand new motion transfer system.
Considering the updated tasks, we designed our rover to be durable under exceptional mechanical stresses, capable of conducting medical adjustments and surviving challenging topography. We are focused on a low backlash and lightweight robotic arm design using a carbon fiber composite structure mixed with aluminum connections. In order to provide motion along Cartesian coordinates, we designed 6 degrees of freedom robotic arm, which is powered by linear actuators and DC motors for the equipment servicing test.
Our drive system is composed of 4 semi-independent continuous track mechanisms to handle numerous obstacles, improve overall traction, and suspense bumps. The system includes several boogies combined with air suspensions to get adaptive contact surface and provide maximum grip. This continuous track mechanism with unique design of track plates allows the rover to strafe sideways to ease robotic arm usage and turns. The drive system can get over obstacles up to 70 cm, climb up to 60 degrees of slopes, and reach a top speed of 17 km per hour. Even though the drive system only weighs 27 kg, it has high resistance to mechanical stresses.
Thanks to the double and effector joint, in addition to our main two-finger gripper, the robotic arm can switch to an interchangeable effector. This adaptive design allows the arm to use a wrench or a keyboard effectively.
This year, our electronics team's main goal was to reduce cost, make system improvements, and simplify configurations. Most PCBs of our rover are designed by the team. Motor drivers are designed to perform close to PID speed and position control for each motor individually with integrated microcontrollers. Real-time kinematic technology integrated GNSS modules made it possible to achieve centimeter level localization.
We decided to use long-range wireless modules with omnidirectional antennas as the main communication system. Low RF modules are chosen as backup for potential signal losses. Our modular smart servo drivers require only 4 cables along the arm. Also, robotic arm can be used individually without needing any connection to the rover.
As a software development team, we have focused on autonomous navigation, image processing, robotic arm control software, and user interface design. We are proceeding our work by using robot operating system. For the autonomous traversal task, our rover can make sensitive localization even without the GPS data. While it can go to given coordinates, rover is able to avoid obstacles using a 3D LiDAR. Also, by using convolutional neural networks on camera feeds, our rover will identify objects within 20 meters.
While developing the robotic arm, we aim to create user-friendly controlling techniques to perform equipment servicing, extreme retrieval, and delivery tasks. Using inverse kinematic process provided us to reach the desired post semi-autonomously. In addition to that, physical replica of the arm is designed. This replica is simultaneously matched with the actual arm to follow the same trajectory. Our ROS-based user interface can be controlled with any device that has a web browser.
As science team, we emphasized on exploring geology and habitability of the area. First, we will observe geological features of the site with onboard cameras to determine possible water-bearing areas.
As a result of laboratory soil simulation test, a core sampler is chosen as the soil collection mechanism. For an efficient and balanced sampling, we located the drilling system at the center of the chassis. In our design, a sterile sampler is mounted on a platform which also carries scientific probes that measure soil characteristics.
For our laboratory test, we plan simple and reliable colorimetric, microscopic, and chromatographic analysis. Also, we designed our own spectrometer. With our visible light spectroscopy, we aim to determine mineralogical information of sample with the help of our collected spectral data. Addition to that, thin layer chromatography and sodium hydroxide nucleophilication reaction will be run for determining organic presence in soil sample.